2.4 billion people in the world have inadequate sanitation. 9 out of 10 people in rural areas open defecate. Women and children in slums are too afraid to use communal toilets at night, forcing them to use plastic bags, which are then discarded on the side of the street. All of this is contributing to 800 children dying needlessly every single day. Whilst teaching in Ghana and travelling around India, I've seen these issues surrounding sanitation, with facilities consisting of pit latrines, which are cheap to build but require emptying, which can be costly, resulting in governments and NGOs sometimes forced to shut them or let them overflow, spreading disease. And the governments see sewage networks with centralised treatment as the pinnacle of wastewater technologies. However, these systems were designed by the Victorians. They combine all of the waste streams together, polluting water, our most valuable resource. These systems are also expensive to install and to maintain. In the UK alone, we have a 100-year replacement cycle on all of our pipes, causing vast water leakages, which these countries cannot afford. It is about time that we start to innovate and develop new systems so these countries can avoid this outdated approach. And this is where my research comes in, as I am looking at decentralised wastewater treatment that allows you to treat the waste locally in its concentrated form, using models based on the circular economy to recover water, nutrients for fertiliser production, and energy that can be used by the locals. I'm designing microbial electrolysis cells. Now, these cells have two compartments. On one side, you have the carbon anode. Now, you grow bacteria on this anode, and this bacteria start breaking down all the organic compounds within the water, just like they do in nature. And you apply a small electrical charge to the cell, and this gives the bacteria a little kick up the backside, just like your morning coffee, and gets them working up a little bit quicker, speeding up the process. On the other side, you have the metal cathode. Now, the combination of the electrical charge and the organic compounds being broken down, you can start producing hydrogen. And this hydrogen can be used as a cooking fuel, replacing coal or wood, which are typically used, and result in deaths from air pollution. Now, I'm just at the start of my research, and in 2 years, I aim to have 2 test sites for feasibility studies, one in the UK and one in India, to look at the economic impact of this system. And eventually, I want to turn sanitation from an economic drain to a system that can generate revenue, to increase investment in the sector, and empower locals so they have the tools that they need to alleviate themselves from poverty.